Hey there, Studivius, Oculus Gamer here, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play. This time we have something special. It's beta version.
Mighty Number 9!
Yes! Fuck yeah!
Mega Man successor with all the drama surrounding it, and the biggest Kickstarter based on a game, I guess you could say.
Yeah, pretty much.
I think it is.
And the first time I heard of Kickstarter.
Yeah. Now the Castlevania guy is doing it.
Oh yeah, everyone is doing a Kickstarter. It's a new trend in video games. Like,
good job, Mr. Infune businessman.
Yeah,
good job.
Camille was totally right. Anyways, I finally got
military base.
The funny part is I didn't even donate for this game, so I got this.
I donated $10, and I kind of regretted it when the whole Dyna controversy sparked out. Something I want to mention about the gameplay, the dashing mechanic. Now, I'm a huge Mega Man fan, for those who don't know. Rayman, Mega Man, Zelda, those are my three favorite franchises. Something about this, and I'm being honest, this is no, like, nostalgia bias. There are a few things that give me kind of a meh impression. It's fun, but it's not... It doesn't... I know it's trying to emulate the feel of classic Mega Man, but sometimes I don't know what it's trying to be with, like, the dash mechanic. Like, it feels like it's trying to be Mega Man X, but
yeah,
that's not
true,
the case.
But, like, if they give me a fucking dash ability, why not give me also ability to wall jump, for fuck's sake, then?
Yeah, exactly. Like, see all these enemies you're just dashing through? Like, here's the thing. When I was playing the beta, I just dashed, right past them, because my Mega Man X instinct was, like, when you play Mega Man X, you don't usually fight your way through, you usually just...
Yeah,
well, I just slash my way through, like, and have no problem, like,
it's probably just
enemy.
A guess, but I think they try to not be too like Mega Man.
They wanted to be original, which is totally fine, but this is supposed to be a Mega Man. Like, I hate the people who say, this can't be like Mega Man, that'd be a ripoff. It's like, well, no shit. Capcom won't even allow Infune to make a new game.
If Inafune had the license, this would be a Mega Man gameplay. It would be the exactly same except different models of enemies, characters, and stuff.
No, it would be better than this, actually. Mega Man Universe.
Yeah, it would be better, but the gameplay-wise, that's what I was trying to say.
I will say I like the lighting in some of these areas. Like, it looks really cool, but the environments just look kind of bleak, in my opinion, compared to, like... Because, like, the Mega Man games, they've always had so much color to them.
I don't know.
Especially the X games.
The graphics in general here, for me, at least...
They look very PS2 quality.
Yes.
That isn't exactly a bad thing. It's just, like, it doesn't look like anything special, in my opinion.
Well, you have to keep in mind, it's just a beta. Maybe they will add some more extras to it.
This is true. They could add more graphical features and enhancements. And it's another thing I wanted to mention, this dashing mechanic into the enemies. It looks cool, but it feels a little repetitive eventually. Like, how every enemy you come across, you just need to constantly dash into them to finish them off.
Yeah, and for a short period of time, you have something extra, like weapon or speed. You gain some extra ability for a short period of time. It's cool, but I wish you could, like, keep, like the same way the classic Mega Man, like, you equip it and you can use it not for a you have the number how many times you can use it, it's not counted by time limits.
Exactly. But Mega Man, and that's another thing, Mega Man has always been about the challenge. I mean, you can argue the games are hard. I disagree. I think they're, like, just the right challenge. Some games have had some really hard moments. One Mega Man game I will say is really hard was Mega Man and Base. A lot of people hate it for that reason, but in this, I mean, it's a beta. It only has three levels, but I didn't really feel like I was being challenged at all.
It just has some cheap deaths at some point and some parts. It's not challenging like enemy wise.
Yeah,
you can get it easy.
Like, I never really struggled once, and that's what I liked about Mega Man is that there was a lot of challenges, and this doesn't feel challenging. And don't get me wrong, I'm not shit-talking Mighty Number 9. I'm really excited for it. It's just... I'm kind of being cautious about it.
So, same. What about you, Omar? What do you think about this whole
Well, you have to see that I'm not really a Mega Man fan, and I didn't really get into Mega Man, except for a few games that I've played so far. But I have mixed feelings about it, to be honest.
Which games have you played? That depends on the feeling a lot. So.
Yeah, I didn't have a really good time playing the X games, but I really liked the first games, especially the collection for the Sega Mega Drive. I don't remember what's called.
Yeah, Wily Wars.
Yes, the Wily Wars.
That's the one with 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, I know a lot of people who don't like, who told me, because X is my favorite. Well, X1, X2, X3, X4, and X5, and everything after that was kind of shit.
Yeah.
But I've heard people tell me they don't like the X games because they're a little too fast-paced, and I guess that's understandable, but holy shit, like, once you get the hang of that, it's just so satisfying blasting through everything.
Exactly. And also, like, I know the YouTube user, he's a Mega Man Pro gamer. He's called Raw Mitril, and he once stated that he doesn't like X series and that he will never do a Let's Play of Mega Man X because the story is too dark for his
taste.
There's
always... Really?
Yes,
there's always people who's... That's what made the X games so awesome.
Yes, I know, and he said he likes only the lighthearted and fun Mega Man
games.
I like
the terrible voice acting of the cutscenes in X4 and the dramatic parts where... I don't want to say what happens... but an important character, something happens to her. Either way, it's just, it's really funny.
Yeah, it sure is, like...
And X sounds like a female.
It's not impressive, like, quality, but unlike for some games, you can actually enjoy and have a good laugh at while playing, so...
Exactly.
That's why I wouldn't mind Let's Playing English version of that game.
X, even though X6 and X7 were really bad games, X8 showed promise for the series, but they just left it there. Well, they also did X Command Mission, which was an RPG. That was also pretty good. But after that, they just left the series, and I don't know. I really, if there's something with the quality of X8, I would not mind seeing another X game.
Many people would like to see 16-bit style. What's your thought on that?
Oh, that's
well,
nice.
Here's my opinion. Oh, you're at the boss.
Yep, and we're going to fucking own him.
Number five. Oh, five. What the fuck? I couldn't read that on my screen.
Well, it's probably a blurry a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little blurry. Either way. Oh, yeah, the 16-bit. I kind of like those stances, by the way. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That is pretty cool. I hope they do that with all the bosses.
Now, the thing I have to say about bosses that I like is... they are a little bit challenging. You need to, but you need, when once you get a
I
pattern.
I heard one of them looked really easy. The water one, like that one looked. I think which number was that again?
Number two.
Number two. Yeah, I found that looked kind of easy. But either way, back to your question about Mega Man X. Do I want to see it 16-bit style? Now here's the thing, Mega Man 9 and 10. They were 8-bit. They went back to the roots, and a lot of people liked that. And while I did like 9 and 10, I was kind of disappointed they didn't do something a little new. Like, it was cool they brought back the 8-bit style, like, that looked really nice, but I kind of wish they did something sort of 2.5D-ish.
Something original, like,
yeah,
because...
2.5D,
I mean,
would be, like something like Powered Up, something like Mega Man Powered Up.
Yeah, I fucking wish they continued Powered Up style. It would be so, so fucking awesome
if they made
other games
in that
style.
Some might not like chibi style too much, but, like, they could just make it, like... normal Mega Man in 3D.
And we just...
Oh, finish.
Finishing move.
Yeah.
Gets a giant hand.
Now, the thing here is they don't explode like in all the Mega Man games. Here, they just become good again. That's what I notice.
Yeah, well, you know.
Well, that's pretty much it for this part. Hope you all guys enjoy it, and see you on the next part. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
See ya.